kids say the darndest things would be an understatement for this film. Joining us now, the star of the number one film in America, Keith L. Williams. Of course, we're referring to Good Boys.
Keith?
Good morning.
Morning.
Keith.
Morning to you, too.
It had to be such a surprise for you to know that this movie is not only number one, but everybody is talking about it.
It was, and I'm, like, really grateful for it. It's amazing.
What did you do when you heard that you had the number one movie in the country?
When I heard that, I was like, really? I didn't know that it was gonna like get this big, you know what
yeah.
I mean?
Yeah.
But you had to know when you were shooting it that there was something special here, that it was really funny.
Yes, it actually was really funny. It was like amazing. Like we were laughing like the entire shoot.
So we've got Seth Rogen behind this film. Have you received any personal congratulations from him or the studio?
From the studio, yes. But Seth is like a really busy guy.
Oh, yeah. What was he like?
He was super nice, yeah. And one of my favorite things about him is his laugh.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
of course. Okay, so now we have all the parental questions. When you're doing this film, and when I say kids say the darndest things, how did your parents perceive you on set saying these things?
From what we hear, very naughty things, Keith.
Yeah, well, my parents... They, like, allowed me to do it, so they were, like, really surprised, like, how I said the things. And that, what, like, when they would look at the script, they were, like, really surprised, like, what I was saying. But they were laughing their heads off, like, the entire shoot also, and watching the movie.
Well, see, on set is one thing, but what happens when you're at home practicing your lines?
My mom told me to practice them in my head.
There you go. You don't want to hear it. You know what, that's smart. Did you guys find, you know, you and your co-stars embarrassed when you were delivering some lines? Would you kind of giggle and laugh about it?
Well, yes, but we're still like on set and around our parents, so we can't laugh at certain things because we're not supposed to know these things.
There you go. You're right. That's smart, Keith.
Yeah. I'm just saying words. I don't
know what they mean.
Yeah. I have no clue. Keith, we've got a clip from Good Boys. Let's take a look.
Just act normal. Pretend to talk.
About what?
Just be normal.
What do you think about politics?
It's a complicated issue.
This cop's acting weird.
Just act normal, just laugh. We're just two cool guys laughing.
We skipped school.
Lucas!
Are we in trouble?
Yeah, well, usually I'd call this in, but because you're honest with me, I'm gonna let you slide, all right? Just promise not to do it again, okay?
We promise. Thank you, sir.
All right.
That was a close one.
That's great. So you've done several films, several commercials, but what was it like working opposite Oscar-nominated Jacob Tremblay?
Well, Jacob's really nice, and he's, like, really funny. Everybody says that we had, like, the weirdest relationship on set.
Yeah.
Because I know, like, the last day we did a photo shoot for these posters that are up now. Mm-hmm. We did that photo shoot the last day we were shooting in Canada. And Jacob, when he was about to leave, he said, "Keith, I've always wanted to do this." And then he squinched my face.
Like, okay.
What, like this?
No, he did like that.
Oh, like this. Okay.
And I like threw his sack in like the ball pit scene that we did. Uh-huh. And I act like his leg was like a bazooka. It was weird.
Yeah. Well, gotta have fun.
Obviously, the off camera chemistry translates to on screen. Keith, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Don't forget, you can catch Good Boys in theaters now.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for coming in.